Prince.
A bad rock star from the late 80s.
Persians, a race of people living around 400 BC.
Sand, covers 30% of the Earth's surface.
Time, an irreversible progression from past through present to future.
So who cares?
Well, put them all together and you get one of the most highly anticipated titles of this year in Prince of Persia, Sands of Time.
Hi, and welcome to the show. I'm Jamie Atiko, and if gaming is your life, then we are your heart, pumping knowledge to all of your extremities.
And I'm Darren Malcolm, and yep, if gaming's in your blood like us, then it's got to be Gamezville. But you're here for a reason. Let me tell you about the treasures going on in Gamezville today. Well, in our face-off zone, we have got Xbox's great racer. It is Group S Challenge, and I tell you what, we've got two gamers who are going to be battling it out for an elite stamp.
And I tell you what, in our Clash of the Titles today, we've got an old favourite going up against a new pretender as Chrome goes plasma to plasma with Halo.
Whew, that's going to be a biggie, Jay.
It is.
I'll tell you what else we've got. We've got the old school guy with the massive forearms in our retro table. I'm talking about Popeye.
Well, I tell you what, Popeye, Daz, let me show you what's going on in Gamezville, because there's plenty more, mate. First of all, people, follow me, because we're off to the PC lounge, where we have got Prince of Persia, Sands of Time. So check this out. If you fancy getting on your PC and exploring exotic worlds and vast kingdoms, then this has got to be the game for you. But get yourself in first gear, because we're off to the console kitchen. And today, we are checking out World Rally Championship 3. Now, to be quite honest with you people, this one has got to be good. With Colin McRae 4 out on the market, Daz will be wasting no time and putting that game through its paces later on in the show. But let's move on, because we've got to take care of handheld gaming. We never forget about mobile gamers. And today, we have got Scooby-Doo Mystery Mayhem. Now, that's going to be played on your GBA. And last, but by no means least, we've got these characters sitting here looking lovely. It's the one and only G-Team. We will be checking in with these guys later on in the show. Now, Daz, you know, people sitting at home, you know, they like Gamezville, but they don't know how to get involved. What can they do?
A simple step, Jamie. All you have to do is email theboys at gamesville.tv.
If you didn't quite catch that, that's theboys at gamesville.tv. How easy was that, Daz?
Absolutely, mate.
Now, mate, if I was to ask you one simple question, what do you want to do now, what would you say to me?
Jay, I'd say let's get gaming.
Let's do it.
Of today's face-off, and we have got thrills and spills for you, because we got three rounds of tire screeching apex to apex action. Now, the choice of weapon is Group S Challenge, and we've got two dueling gamers. Now, our first gamer is Marcus. Marcus, welcome to Gamezville.
Hi.
Now, I mean, you guys are here for a reason. You're here to settle the score. What's the grudge? Tell us all about
it. Well, he loves football, and I love basketball, and he's trying to put down basketball and say that football's a better game.
Ooh, so, I mean, you're not having that, are you?
No, so I have to settle it here.
Right, on the driving game?
Yeah.
So, I mean, how good are your driving skills? What kind of games are you into?
Good. Gran Turismo games, like.
Yeah, basically. Definitely. I mean, Gran Turismo, when a gamer comes on, he says Gran Turismo, I know he's a driving man. Looking forward to it, Marcus.
Let's meet our second gamer. His name is Akhtar. How you doing?
Easy, cool. I'm cool.
Now, tell me a bit about yourself, mate. What console you got at home?
PS2.
PS2? And you're on the Xbox today. That's not going to be a problem, is it?
Nah, not too much.
Nah? No? What kind of games do you usually play when you're at home?
Action and missionary games and all that fun. Adventures.
Well, you know what, mate? You've got an adventure, a mission and lots of action here today because you're in the face-off zone. And it's all about driving skills, so... Tell me, how are your driving skills? Because your boy over there, he sounds pretty good.
Fairly good, but I'll put it to the test.
Are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm all
ready. I mean, you've got all your support behind you, supporting you today. You can't let everyone down. You're gonna show us what you got, yeah?
Yeah.
We've got a ready game here, Daz.
Definitely, Jay. Well, this game features some of the best licensed cars you're ever gonna see. 20 tracks and some of the best real-world locations. Mm-hmm. Have a look at this.
It's not hard to compare Group S Challenge with the Gran Turismo series. The pumping soundtrack, the licensed cars, and the eye-candy graphics. But where this game differs is its handling. Steering clear of the ultra-realistic sensation of GT, Group S Challenge goes for a more arcadey feel, although it still remains an in-depth game. Whether it's a GT beta is debatable, but what we do know is that it makes a great face-off.
Right, our gamers are in first gear and their clutch is just on biting point. But before we let them go, let's explain some rules. Now, face-offs are split into three rounds throughout the show. And each round is going to be a two-lap race. Whoever's past the finish line first wins. It's as simple as that, right?
It is, Jay.
Now, guys, get your pads in your hands because it's time to show and prove. After the count, 3, 2, 1, let the games begin! There by Marcus.
It was very slick.
Come on, Axel! Come on, Marcus! But at the moment, we're still on the first lap. All still to play for. Loads more racing action to go.
Oh, what a chicken! Did you see the way Marcus said that chicken?
Absolutely.
Now, we've got my boy Marcus. He's in the red car on the bottom screen.
Axel, you've got to break before the corners, mate. You're going straight into the barriers.
Marcus, nice and steady. You're doing great, man.
He's got him at 7 seconds, guys. And I think it could go up. It's absolute pandemonium at my side here.
Oh, Marcus is just... he's just flying, Jamie.
Well, actor, Marcus made a little mistake there. So break nice and early.
He's just flying. Oh! And it looks as if he's cracked, Jamie.
I mean, that has just sealed it. I think Marcus has just done enough there. We'll see what happens.
Okay.
There's about that much in it.
There is that much in it. It's very close. Now, Marcus is coming up.
He's coming home straight.
He's coming up to the home straight. We have a winner in round one. And man, that was a smooth, smooth drive. It was like a Sunday drive, right, Marcus?
Yes, it's easy as that.
Yeah, you just like let your hair down, just like chilled out and just, you know, took your time around the course. He put you in the pressure at the beginning, but you definitely, definitely came through very well. Well done, Marcus. Great round from you.
Marcus did very well. Actor, you've got to come back in round two. Don't worry about round one. It's all over with now. But, you know, you've got your support. You've got me backing you. Round two is all important. Right now, though, guys, let's check out our first review.
Right, things are heating up in the console kitchen because we're taking a look at World Rally Championship 3. Now, I'm a big fan of rally games. Now, I'm pretty good on tarmac, but rally is a whole different B game. Now, I like my games challenging, and more often than not, you always get that in a rally game, which is why I'm looking forward to checking out our next title. Now, I want to know, will it make the grade or will it end up in the mud? In the meantime, have a look at this.
The whole rallying genre is hardly short of excellent titles. Codemasters' Colin McRae series, Atari's V-Rally, and Sony's WRC chain all cranking out superb games. Now, with the 2003 World Championship tied up, Sony have released WRC 3, featuring all the cars, all the courses, and all the drivers. Well, nearly all. Not surprisingly, you can't play as McRae, but you can play as championship winner Petter Solberg. Developers Evolution Studios claim to have broken technological boundaries in terms of graphics, with bodywork and glass flying off the cars and a more detailed collision and damage mode. Apart from the championship modes, you can choose to race a single rally or dive straight into the action. So, do we need another mud-splattering game, or is this a course too far?
All right, so Si, I mean, there are a whole load of rally games on the market. Obviously, the market leader's got to be Colin McRae 4. Yep. How realistic is this compared to Colin McRae?
Compared to Colin McRae, it's a difficult call, actually. None of the rally games are amazingly realistic.
Yeah.
With Colin McRae, they tried to make it really realistic, and then in beta testing, they realised that it was just too real, and they actually dumbed it down a little bit. With this game, it's as if they dumbed it down just a little bit further than Colin McRae 4.
So, I mean, tell me some about some of the cars that are featured in this. Is it the official cars of the World Rally Championship?
Not only is it the official cars, it's the official drivers. All except Colin, of course.
Of course, yeah, because he's got his own game.
He's got his own game. And all the official events as well. So, and you can actually go through the entire 2003 season, have to think about that.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I mean, the World Championship this year was taken, you know, and you can play any driver you like.
So, I mean, like any great game, multiplayer, any great car game, it's got to have a multiplayer.
Yeah, and actually, this has got four-way multiplayer. Now, nothing online, but four-player multiplayer, and it works really well. Very, very little slowdown, although the detail in the background is not quite as good, obviously, in multiplayer.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Well, we've got our gamer Mustafa over here. Now, Mustafa, you a big driving fan?
Yeah.
Yeah? Love your driving games?
Yeah.
All right, so what do you think of this? What do you think of World Rally Championship?
It ain't as good as Colin McRae's, but...
Yeah. Pretty good?
It's all right, yeah. It's decent. It's a decent driving game, but the terrain's a bit,
Not detailed enough. What are your favourite elements of the game?
The way the headlights are shown. Yeah. And how, like, the car's representation.
Yeah, just a little, just those little bits of attention to detail that make the game, right?
Yeah.
Well, Mustafa seems pretty happy with it, so give me a G rating.
Okay, excellent graphics, great gameplay. It's the second best rally game there is out there. It's going to get a solid 4 Gs.
Well, that is very decent. World Rally Championship 3 on your PlayStation 2 gets a very decent 4 Gs. Now, if I was to tell you to trust a man with swirly eyes who lives in a hovel and wears a habit, would you believe me? Not unless it was the guru. It's time to see the Master of Knowledge.
Was that a joke? Oh dear. Who needs me now? Mitz Deedles, he writes Guru. Can you give me Cheats for Kung Fu Chaos on that Xbox, please? I would rather give you a dictionary, my friend, so you can learn how to spell. However, you have asked me for my wisdom, and I shall not fail. Listen. At the main menu, press and hold in the left analog stick. Now press left, A, down, Y. Right, A, down, A, right. The level select option is now yours, my friend. That should make your kung fu a little less chaotic. Next.
Games Guru, how can I do perfect manuals on Tony Hawk's Underground on the GameCube? I keep falling off my board.
In order to do perfect manuals, you must strike the balance between up and down, keeping your character upright at all times. And, I see. You were after a cheat, weren't you? Not the correct way to do it. In which case, my friend, what you must do is keep it steady. I have it. You must keep it steady. Go to the cheat code entry screen and enter the code. Keep it steady. You will now have perfect manual rolls. You will never fall again. Perfect in every way. Just like the guru.
Guru, you should learn to blink now and again. It might improve your eyesight. Now, if you need some gaming advice from the man upstairs, send your emails to guru@gamesville.tv.
And UK digital satellite viewers, if you've missed any of the great man's words, don't worry about it. Just pick up that remote control and simply press your red button.
Now, coming up on the show, Sarah has got some great gaming gadgets for us, including a device that lets you game in the backseat of your car.
I'm not believing that for a second.
I'm telling you, Jay.
For real?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, we've got another frantic race coming up in our face-off arena as our gamers head for the continent for some more street racing action. That's all coming up right here on Gamezville. You'd be crazy to go anywhere.
Now, if you just tuned in to this hardcore gaming fun, let me enlighten you on what's going on. We've got two gamers battling it out on Group S Challenge. We've got my boy Marcus. He's one round up at the moment. More about that in a second, because coming up, we've still got more essential news from our G team.
And we've got a massive PC review for you, truly huge, as we find out what all the fuss is about in Prince of Persia, Sands of Time. But right now, people, strap your seatbelts on, because it's round two of our face-off! Now, pan this way, camera pan this way. Look at this gamer. This is a very determined man right now because he lost the first round. But round two is here, and what are you going to bring to the table, my friend?
More power, more acceleration, more speed.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And more braking. Don't worry about speed, you've got to be able to control the speed as well.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
Brake before you get to them corners, yeah?
Luck was in his first line, man.
Right, well, we'll see what happens in round two. All to play for, D.
Marcus, man, we all know it wasn't luck, innit?
No.
We know that it was pure driving skill, don't we?
Yeah?
I mean, you know, what else are you going to bring to the table in round two?
Just do the same.
Yeah?
Just do the same.
He knows it was skill as well, you know that, don't you? All right. Well, this is round two, and I'll tell you what, I can't wait for it to get underway. So, guys, pick up your pads, please.
Mm-hmm.
Right, we are on the Monaco circuit, and this is a very tough, twisty circuit. After the count of three, 3, 2, 1, let the games begin!
Yeah.
Atiko, you're still in it, mate.
Beautiful, Marcus.
That's a reminder. I call driving in style. Now, Marcus, you won round one and round two was just a walk in the park, basically, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's just the same thing.
Yeah? So, I mean, you're two rounds ahead. Surely you must be thinking whitewash.
Yeah,
3-0.
Obviously.
Yeah?
Yeah, whitewash.
I mean, are we going to go for that?
Yeah.
I reckon it's going to be an easy task, what do you reckon? Yeah? All right, top stuff.
Round three, you're playing for pride, my friend. You are playing for pride. It's 2-0 down. I don't know what to say. I don't want to put too much pressure on his shoulders. But round three is all about your pride and saving face. Right, now it's time to see some people who have never lost any pride because they're just too good. It's the one and only G Team.
Matt, what's the lowdown, bro?
I've got some terrifying news for you. It's not actually terrifying, but it's disappointing. Xbox 2 isn't going to be backwards compatible as I speak at the moment.
Now, when you say backwards compatible, explain.
I mean, it's not going to work with Xbox games. So, say you love the Xbox, okay, and you've got a big library of games, you want to upgrade when the new one comes out, it's more powerful, but you may still like some of your older games.
Of course.
You don't really want both the consoles, you know, you'd want to sell off your old one. I mean, there's a big petition at the moment. There's already thousands of names already signed to it online. You know, people are signing up saying, please make it backwards compatible.
Completely.
The reason being that their new IBM processor isn't compatible with the old Pentium processor.
Yeah.
So, it's because they're changing chipsets. But
so,
I'm
it's
sure
probably
they can...
because of a movement in technology. They can't really...
Well, exactly, but I'm sure, you know, those clever bods at Microsoft can do a bit of digging
Microsoft
under the bonnet and sort it out.
Take note of that one, you know.
Sort it.
Pull your finger out. Nice one, Matt. How you doing, Si? You all right, bro?
Yeah, really good, Dad. Really
good. What's the latest on your end of the woods?
Actually, I've got some bad news for Nokia this week.
Oh, bad news for Xbox, bad news for Nokia. What's going on?
Yeah, well, apparently it's just been revealed. Well, there's a lot of websites reporting that the Nokia N-Gage has had its security cracked, which means that a lot of the software that runs on the N-Gage...
Can be copied.
Well, now it will be able to run on different mobile phones, any phone using the same sort of Symbian operating system.
Now, I thought that what made the N-Gage so special was because it was such a powerful machine, it used a different processor from all the other phones,
That's
right?
That's what we all thought, yeah, but it appears, I mean, one site in particular is reporting that the Siemens SX1 is capable of running Sonic M.
So, I mean, that really doesn't make the N-Gage that special anymore, does it?
Well, that's the case at the moment. I mean, there's also the danger of third-party developers creating like hardware which would allow people to download Nokia N-Gage games to their phone. But Nokia have commented just recently that they're taking the reports very seriously, and anyone copying their games are going to be committing serious crime.
We don't condone that kind of thing here at Games. Also, be very careful. Well done, Si. Jamie.
Nice one, Daz. Now, speaking of copying, I don't want anyone trying to copy what we're about to give you, because we're about to give you two great free downloadables from the World Wide Web. I didn't find them. Sarah found them, because she's our freebie specialist, isn't you, sir?
Yes, I am.
Yes, you are.
I didn't actually find this one. This was a recommendation from one of our viewers.
Oh, for real?
Nick French, who's 12, who comes from Surrey, and he likes playing this one. It's a game called Smosh Strike.
Smosh.
And you've got this Gorzan species of aliens that are coming after you, and you've got to take them out, basically. They come from all sides. It's an easy game to play. Well, it starts off quite easy, actually, but it gets faster and faster. So when you're, like, trying to attack them all, you've got, like, shields that you can pick up, power-ups, and also you've got this huge laser that can, like, get really big, or then it's, tiny again.
Right, now this one... is something I'm getting very excited about.
Very exciting, yes. This is Hidden and Dangerous, and it's the full game with added extras as well. Lovely third-person shooter. There are first-person shooter modes that you can play, but anyone who's into tactical strategy combat, this is one for
them. Sorry, Sarah, did you say you get the whole game?
Yeah, the full game.
The full game, and it's free?
Yes, for free.
That is crazy. Well, you lucky gamers, get on that one. I certainly will be. Now, people, you know, you're sitting at home, you've got a question for me or Daz or anyone here on the G team, but you don't know how to send it, it's very easy. It's theboys@gamesville.tv. That's theboys@gamesville.tv. Now, I can see my co-P walking away. It must be gadgets time.
Thanks, Jay. Now, you know I love gaming, but I love a good gadget, which is why I'm talking to Sarah, and she's going to be enlightening me about two gadgets that I know I'm going to love, Sir. So, what's the first one?
This one is the TechSet SIM Key, and it's like a mini personal organiser that you can have on your keyring, but it's been designed to work with your SIM card from your phone. So, if you were to lose your phone, you've got all your SIM card details backed up on this little thing.
Now, this is perfect for me because, as Jamie knows, I'm always losing my phone and I never have anything to back it up with. So once I lose my phone, that's it, my numbers have gone.
So it's all in here, and then you take the SIM card back out again, put it back in your phone, but you've got a permanent log here.
Brilliant.
Different languages.
Oh, right.
It's got a calendar, it's got a little memo space as well, so you can actually edit your contact details and things and then eventually put them back onto your SIM card if you want. So if you remember something, you haven't got your phone on you, pop it in here and then you can transfer it back onto
your SIM
card.
And that's all in this little thing here?
Yeah.
That's brilliant. So how much is this going to set me back, sir?
£14.
£14, very good.
Also, it's password protected, so no one can get all your details.
Oh, that just improves it for me, sir. So what's the next gadget?
Next gadget. Now, these are amazing. It's a pair of gadgets which will basically turn your PS2 into in-car entertainment. You've got this screen here. It's Joytech screen, and it's lovely quality, you know, perfect. It's got really wide angle, so you can have two people watching it at the same time, playing their games, 130 degrees, so it's nice.
That is amazing.
But it actually, the perfect companion is this. And this is the in-car adapter, which allows you to game in the back seat of a car.
So basically, you plug this bit into your PlayStation, plug this bit into the lighter in your car.
The lighter socket, yeah, perfect. That's £100, that's £30. So for £130, you've got in-car entertainment.
I can see that the screen is quite small and they've put on really big speakers, so the sound must be pretty good, right, sir?
It's 3D surround sound.
Perfect. Two absolutely amazing gadgets, sir. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
You're the gadget girl.
Right, I'm in the PC Lounge where we're looking at Prince of Persia, Sands of Time. Now, this game is all about triumph and betrayal, and it's been brought to us by the same studio that brought us Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. Could this be the new era of action-adventure? See what you think.
In Prince of Persia, the Sands of Time, the prince returns in a 3D action-adventure full of gravity-defying acrobatics, ferocious fighting combos, and the ability to bend time to fulfill his destiny. Helped by a seductive princess and the power of the Sands of Time, the prince embarks on a harrowing quest to reclaim the palace's cursed chambers and restore peace to the very fabric of time itself. Full of deadly creatures and epic legends, this new title promises to deliver as much originality and groundbreaking technology as the original 1989 classic.
Right, now, Matt, I've got to be honest, I'm quite excited about this one. I can't wait to get started. So tell me, I mean, how does this compare to other third-person action-adventure games out there?
This, to be honest, blows everything out of the water that I've seen.
Seriously?
Ever, when it comes to this sort of exploration, sort of running around tombs, definitely. We know,
wow.
We all know that a certain game that probably should have been like this, and this is fantastic.
How does it play? I mean, let's talk us through typical bit of gameplay.
It plays really well. It's really fluid. You play this prince who's he gets hold of this dagger, and then he can reverse time.
Okay.
So as well as being able to obviously fight with his sword, do loads of running and jumping, he can also like run up walls, Matrix style, and things like that. So it's a bit of a convergence of lots of different styles that we haven't seen done as well as this in other games.
Right.
And they've just put this sort of sheen on it, this lovely sort of silver sheen that just makes it fantastic. This is polished as it can be.
Now, you mentioned daggers and time, yeah? So, I mean, tell me how the Sands of Time work.
Yeah, this is really good. Say you're playing Tomb Raider and you think, can I get across this gap? I'll try it. Oh, no, I couldn't. I've died. I have to go back to the restart point. This is really clever because you can try doing these jumps. You can take risks. And if it doesn't work, as you're plummeting to your doom, you hit this button which sort of reverses time. So you're falling off a cliff and you go, and everything comes back.
Have you ever seen that before?
I've never seen it before. No, it's really a good idea. You can also do it with fighting people as well. You're losing energy. Hit the button. You can reverse it.
You can reverse it.
You can just reverse time and then, you know, do things differently. It's
really
clever. You know, I wish I could really do it in real life sometimes.
Exactly, yeah.
Especially
when you miss your bus in the morning.
Exactly, yeah. If you say the wrong thing in front of someone, it would have been really good.
Now, let's meet our gamer. His name is Camille. How are you doing?
I'm doing okay, yeah.
Now, you've busily got the joypad in your hand. You won't be able to see it, but he's busily gaming. What's your first impressions, mate?
Lovely, beautiful game. I like Miss Tomb Raider and Matrix mixed together.
Any bad points? Anything you don't like about it?
No, nothing. Everything's excellent.
So it gets a big thumbs up from you.
Yep.
Nice one, Camille. Now, Matt, give me a G rating.
This can only be a 5G game. It's what Tomb Raider should have been.
What you heard? Now, did you hear that quote from the Cuttle himself? It's what Tomb Raider should have been. Now, it's official. Prince of Persia, Sands of Time, gets an official bank-busting 5 Gs. Fantastic score, I have to say. Now, at the moment, it's time to switch it all up a little bit. Get yourself in first gear, make sure your driving gloves are nicely fitted, because we've got two gamers with a very serious grudge. Now, one of them's in a pretty good position. Can the other one claw it back? Let's find out.
The third and final round of our face-off. Now, guys, if you just tuned in, let me fill you in on what's going on. We've got today's face-off champion already after only two rounds. It's my gamer, Marcus, and we are playing Group S Challenge on the Xbox. And he beat his mate, Actor, who is now playing for pride in the third and final round, Jay.
Absolutely. Actor, you're going to get your pride, aren't you, bro?
Yep.
Now, you know, let's talk about a little slight change of tactics here, because round one and two, not been going too well. Now, there's a little thing called the corner.
Yeah, I know,
it's got, like, barriers around it.
Yeah,
and you've got to break before you get there.
Yeah,
so
I didn't
just
see it. I'm not looking at that.
Yeah?
I didn't
well,
see that.
Pay a little attention to this map here, yeah? Plan your corners, mate. Nice one, bruv. I think he's ready for round three. Now, I think he's going to get some pride, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice one.
All right. Guys, pick up your pads. This is the third and final round. OK, three, two, one. Let the games begin! All right, so Marcus is in the red, Mitsubishi on the bottom screen. And my boy Actor, he's playing for pride. He's in a blue Subaru, and he needs round three.
Desperately.
He does, Jamie. This is all about pride for Marcus. Oh, it's all about pride for your boy, Actor. Marcus almost got past him, but Actor's using different tactics.
Yeah, Actor's the blocky mark.
Yeah, he's going for the argy bargy.
When he breaks, you break.
Come on, Marcus!
Oh, Marcus took that. She came very well.
Marcus is a class act, Jamie.
Yeah, it's really, really good.
And he's
playing
a class
analog as well, which is,
yeah, which is very interesting. They're both are, actually.
Yeah, they are indeed.
I prefer the D-pad myself.
Yep, I'm a D-pad man myself.
Come on,
Jamie.
Well, we'll see what happens now. That's much better.
Come on, Marcus, that's it. Stick with it, mate.
That's much better, bro.
Much better. Stop. Now, Marcus is just taking his corners nice and easy. He's rushing him.
And now we can see Marcus in our view. Can we get close enough to remind everyone? Actor is on the top screen. And he's playing for pride right now.
Come on, Marcus, mate. You can do it. Just a little way to go. And this race is yours.
Marcus is not far from the finish line.
It's how how you dish out a 3-0 whitewash here on Gamezville. He did it in style and he did it with a smile. His name is Marcus. Marcus, that's got to feel great.
Yeah, it's just great. It's easy. Yeah?
I mean, you know, did he feel under pressure at all?
No, it's simple.
Well, you are today's face-off champion, Marcus, and I'm very happy for you. But there is a question about a little elite stamp. Now, to earn it, you've got to play me in our face-off. How are you feeling about that?
All right, I'd rather face Jamie, but...
Well, there's no Jamie today, Marcus. It's all about Daz, mate.
It's all about the driving specialist for you, Marcus. Now, actor, talk to me, mate. What happened?
Just the corners and the turning just flopped on me. Yeah. That's it.
He was great on the straights, but just couldn't handle the corners.
Yeah.
Innit?
Yeah.
Never mind. Look, this is a very difficult game, and I've played this myself. It's not easy. It takes a lot of skill. But let me ask you, mate, did you have fun?
Yeah?
Can we get a handshake as well?
Well done, guys.
Yeah.
Well done.
Now, we'll be seeing what happens in the Elite Final later on. I certainly can't wait for that one. But right now, let's go from some of the best cars in the world to the best gamer in the world. It's the one and only Games Guru.
I sense there are mortals who seek my gaming guidance. I must assist them. Who needs me now? Benny Buddha's Red's Guru on NBA Street Volume 2. Is there a way to unlock everything? Benny Boo, if you wish to unlock everything on this game, you must be prepared to work and actually play the game. Imagine that. However, I can give you a little helping hand. How about all of the courts? Yes, all of the courts should do it. Listen. Go to the Enter Codes Now screen, hold L1 and L2, and enter circle, square. All of the courts are now yours, Benny Boo. Play. Next.
Guru, I want a bigger ball in Outlaw Golf on the GameCube. Is there a way to get one?
Okay, Amelia. A quick lesson in sport. Football, big ball. Golf, little ball. Football, golf. It's a strange one. But allow me to search my vast memory banks. You are in luck. I have such a cheat. Listen. During gameplay, hold the left shoulder button. Now push up, 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 down. You will now be able to play with a bigger ball. Enjoy.
Guru. I feel more and more enlightened every time I hear your voice, my friend. Cheers. Now, if you want to feel enlightened, you know what to do. Send your emails to guru@gamesville.tv.
And UK digital satellite viewers, you can also get in on the action. Just press that red button on your remote. It's as simple as that.
It is indeed. Now, still to come, everyone's favourite dog, Scooby-Dooby-Doo, will be making his appearance on your GBA.
Stick to your representing, Jake. Not very good impression, mate. And Chrome tries to outshine Halo in our futuristic first-person shooter, Clash of the Titles. It's going to be a big one. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after the break.
The greatest gaming show on your TV. Now, if you've just joined us, you've missed loads of the show and you don't want to do it again. But don't worry, because we've got loads more coming up, including the good old retro table. Yes, we'll be going back to 1982 to check in with that old character who loves necking spinach. It's the one and only Popeye.
And we've got more cartoon capers in our mobile pad too as we check out Scooby-Doo on your GBA. That's coming up later. But right now, it's time to jump into our battle suits because it's time for our alien Clash of the Titles. Now, this was sent in by a beautiful little gamer. Her name is Julie from Stockport, and she wanted to know which is the best, Chrome or Halo? Well, Julie, you're about to find out. Let me enlighten you, because I am playing Halo on the Xbox.
And I am playing Chrome on the PC. And let me take it away. Chrome is a massively underrated tactical first-person shooter with an excellent plot, full of sci-fi action, 14 enormous and varied missions. Just like Halo, you get to drive 6 futuristic vehicles. You go on stealth missions, and not only that, you go on plasma gun firing fests. That D.
So, stealth missions, was it, Jay? Well, anyway, this is the best reason Microsoft ever gave us to buy an Xbox. It was initially meant as a PC game, but when Microsoft bought Bungie, the company that made it, they switched it to an Xbox exclusive because they understood, They overstood what a hit this game would be. The controls are class, simple and effective. Graphics were groundbreaking, and due to the power of the Xbox, it made this game the most beautiful thing I have ever seen on any console in my life. The only game to beat this is Halo 2. G-Team, give us your verdict.
This is quite a tough one. Chrome, it's got more weapons, it's newer, it's got better graphics, it's got very good AI, it's got more vehicles. But at the end of the day, it's just copying Halo, isn't it? Halo wins it.
Woo! What can I say? I'm a saint. Halo is today's Clash of the Titles winner. You're right, mate.
Hey. Oh, we've got a result, yeah?
Don't try it.
Chrome just engrossed me so much, I just couldn't get off it. Sorry, Des.
Right, handheld gamers, pay attention because I've got something very special for you. Now, if you're a Scooby-Doo fan, you're going to like our next game, right, Sir?
Yeah, definitely.
So what
it's
are we
a real
at?
Scooby-Doo fan. It's Scooby-Doo Mystery Mayhem.
Okay.
It starts off, well, it's like playing the cartoon, basically. You start off, you find out that it's a typical Scooby adventure. You've got a mystery to solve. It involves lots of ghosts and ghouls.
Yeah, the way Scooby
and
does.
They're going to split up, and Shaggy and Scooby are going to do all the really scary things like the dodgy basement down below and you know, the haunted library.
I mean, I was a big fan of the cartoon. I won't lie. I love Scooby-Doo. He's so cool, but I mean, you know, how does the game transfer onto the GBA?
It's just like playing the cartoon.
Really?
I mean, you're running around, it's a little platform puzzler.
Yeah.
You've got things to sort out on the way, like you've got to find a red key to open a red door. There's little puzzles that you've got to do. But you've also got to avoid all these ghosts that are flying around in the air. And if you creep past the ghosts, you can actually they won't see you, so it doesn't matter. You can
right,
sort of, like,
so there's like a little sneak 'em up kind of move that you can do.
Press B and they all get on their toes and they like sneak past. And they'll hide behind pillars as well, which is really cool. And you get that noise as well, which is really good. But if the ghosts catch them, then they go really pale and they're frightened and you have to get Scooby snacks.
Now, I was going to say, actually, I know Scooby was a huge fan of Scooby snacks. What part do they play in the game?
Well, basically, every time they're scared, Scooby snacks will give them courage, so they've got to eat their Scooby snacks regularly. It's really cool.
That's wicked. So, I mean, you know, graphically, how does it look? Does it look really cool, sir?
Graphically, it looks lovely, actually. It's nicely presented.
Yeah.
The platform, a little puzzle sometimes can get a bit tedious, maybe. Mm. I don't know. And sometimes it's a little bit too in your face. You need to see the bigger picture. But
now,
then
how
you just
do you actually do that?
Hold down left, and then you can scroll around, so you can sort of just see around you, so you know where you've got to jump next.
Right, OK.
But it does play really well.
Lastly, sir, I'm going to ask you for a G rating.
I think, well, maybe for the older gamer, they might not like the puzzle so much, but I'm going to give it a 3 Gs.
3 Gs? Mm-hmm. Whew, very decent. Well, Scooby-Doo on your GBA gets a very decent 3 Gs. Well, from cartoon capers to some retro cartoon capers, it's time to check out what's going on the retro table.
Right, let me give you a little task to do. Go and find your nearest dictionary and look up the word retro, and you're probably going to see this gentleman's face right next to it. Because he is our retro specialist. And Matt, what have we got on the table today, mate?
We've got Popeye 1982 on the arcade.
Good old Popeye, yeah?
Good old Popeye, yeah. What you have to do in this game is you have to collect the hearts and the musical notes and the hail signs that olive oil would throw out. And of course, you had to avoid Bluto as well, who was after you, that big hairy
big old
of a man.
Bluto.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. It was really hard as well, to be honest. You had three different levels to do it over. And you could only fight Bluto if you collected your spinach.
Of course.
Yeah, exactly.
What is Popeye without your spinach?
Exactly.
Come
so
on,
you used to punch the can, obviously you'd neck the spinach, and then for 10 seconds you'd glow and you could fight Bluto. You'd knock him into the sea, you get 3,000.
You'd have arms like Daz for 10 seconds.
Exactly, just for 10 seconds, and then you end up with arms like me.
Now, for people who've never seen Popeye before, I mean, what are they missing? I mean, what was so good about it?
Well, it just looked like the cartoon. It was really difficult, to be honest, and I wouldn't attempt playing it because you'll just get annoyed if you try playing it again.
I mean, is this a game nowadays that, you know, people can get into, or should it just be left where it, you know,
it's worth
place?
A look if you're a Popeye fan. You know, I mean, Popeye, he's not around too much nowadays,
is he?
So, I mean, some viewers may not even know who Popeye is.
Actually, Matt, that's a good question. What happened to Popeye, mate?
I don't know, maybe he just sailed off into the distance. Who knows?
If anyone out there is watching the show and you know what happened to Popeye, let us know. The boys at Gamesville.tv. Also, Popeye, if you're watching yourself, mate, send us a message. We want to know what happened to you. Matt, just like to say a huge thank you, mate, for sharing your retro knowledge with us. Remember, pick up a dictionary, look up the word retro, you're probably going to see his face. But if you want to meet our next gentleman in the dictionary, you're going to have to look up the word wisdom. And you know whose face that's going to be. It's the one and only Games Guru.
Ask the Guru. If you were to look up stylish and handsome, you would also see this face. Who wishes to ask the Guru? Fabian Gerrit, as he writes, Guru, is it true that you could play NES online? P.S. You rock.
Fabian, I am aware that I rock. However, you have asked about the NES playing online. It's a strange idea. An 8-bit console from the 80s going online. But it's true. In 1988, the Nintendo Entertainment System went online in Japan. Imagine. But it's also funny that the company that first put their console online now seems to show little interest with the GameCube. Strange. Next. Yo, Guru, will there ever be any PS2 games which have Nintendo characters in them? Barry Cogan. Barry, a few years ago I would have dismissed this question out of hand and ridiculed you for asking. However, I never expected to see a Sega game on a Nintendo console. It is highly unlikely that Nintendo will ever make games for the PS2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7. However, one day they may do a Sega and make games only. I wouldn't count on it, Barry.
Because it's the face-off finale. This is the time when we really do separate the men from the mice. Yeah, we get a lot of good gamers here at Gamezville, but we don't get many elite gamers. And that's what my boy is trying to do. Marcus is trying to get an elite stamp right about, I don't know, here. But to do that, he's got to take on Daz and Group S Challenge on the Xbox in a face-off. Now, Marcus, let me come to you without wasting any more time. How you feeling now, boss?
All right.
Yeah? Now, I mean, you beat your mate Akhtar 3-0, so your confidence levels must be pretty good right now.
Yeah, pretty high.
But you're up against a whole new breed of animal right now, you know, because you're going up against Daz. Now, I mean, I heard someone say he's a tiger in the background, and you know what? He's not far from it. So, I mean, you ready?
Yeah.
Right, I'm about to get this on. Will we get an elite stamp here? There's only one way to find out. Pads in hands, gentlemen. Daz, you ready?
Yeah, mate.
Marcus, you ready?
Yeah.
Audience, are we ready?
Yeah!
Okay. 3, 2, 1, let the games begin! Who's on the top screen? And we got Marcus on the bottom screen! Now Daz is actually inside the car. He's got a different driving view to Marcus. And Marcus is actually just behind the car. It's gonna be a very close race. At the moment, Daz is slightly in the lead. And Marcus making a slight mistake. A driving specialist, Daz. Give the nation a few words, man.
Listen, man, this is a guy that gave me a very good race. It was mad close. You put me under some serious pressure, Marcus. Top gamer.
Serious pressure. Marcus, listen, mate, you didn't get the elite stamp, but you did very well. You got a whitewash and you gave Daz a good old scare. And you are today's face-off champion! Look in that camera, my friend, and tell the nation what you have to do to be a face-off champion. How'd you do it, boss?
Well, you have to just pick a fast car and be able to control it.
Absolutely. Be able to control it. That's the key word. And you were able to control it. You did very, very well. Now, I've got to tell you, this is my worst part of the show because it's the end. I know, dude. I know. I hate it when it gets to this time. But you know what? The fun doesn't stop for UK digital satellite viewers. By a simple press of the red button, you can get gaming. Yes, you can get gaming. You can get hints, cheats, and tips from the great man upstairs, the one and only guru, and there's lots, lots more to get involved with. Just press the button and you see what I mean.
Absolutely. And as Jay said, that is the end of the show. But you know where to come for the best in hardcore gaming action!
Tune in for another all-new Gamesville lesson at the same time tomorrow. Back to today, though, and the Animix is in full swing over on Mix now, whilst here on Sky One next, it's your customary triple Star Trek Voyager.